In this module, we will study oligonucleotide ligation assay. It is abbreviated as OLA, and it is commonly used to detect the mutations in a gene, SNPs, that are associated with human diseases. In this assay, we used three probes. Two probes that are allele specific, and one probe that is common. And I illustrate this, how this assay works, I illustrate through a figure. In this figure, you can see there are total three probes. On the left side, these two are allele specific probe. And on the right side is common probe. In the first step, the target sequence is PCR amplified. And then we add wild type probe, and in the second reaction we add a mutant target probe, and in both of these tubes we add common probe. So tube number one will contain wild type target probe plus common probe, and tube number two, that is on the right side, that will contain mutant target probe plus the common probe. If the idea is if both probes, if the wild-type probe will perfectly bind at its sequence and common probe will bind very next to the wild-type probe, and if the wild-type probe is perfectly bound at its target sequence, then we will add, in the next step, we add ligase that will attach both the wild-type target probe and the common probe. In the second tube, that is on the right side, if there is a mutation in the target sequence, now the mutant target probe will bind on the sequence. And if there is no mutation, the mutant probe will not perfectly bind at its target sequence. And since the common probe is binding very next to the probe, so in this case, ligase will not be able to ligate these two probes. So, if ligation works, it means both probes have bound perfectly. And if there is no ligation, it means one of probe has not bound at its target sequence. Now, how to detect whether ligation has occurred or not? The probes are attached with a fluorescence indicator. We can attach a different color fluorescence with a wild-type probe, and an other different color fluorophore with a mutant probe. So due to this different color, we are able to know whether ligation has occurred or not. And if ligation has occurred, we can detect what kind of sequence is it through the different colors of the fluorophores.